Oh boy. If you only knew how long I've been trying to figure out how to do this one. Comparing how the Headers and how Rolaska Talks did collectively on their respective seasons was not an easy job. First, I had to figure out how I was going to compare them. Was I going to add up all of their respective scores, then compare? Or was I going to go by percentages? Or was I going to look for an overall score with the two groups? And for every single one of these, I could find a flaw in the system immediately, so I had to think deeper. We also can't look at them separately, because maybe one queen from one group did better than the other queens in the other group, but cumulatively, the other group did better. The weird thing is, I know that Rolaska Talks did better than the Headers. Delta and Carmen really underperformed in season 3, and thus, they're bringing down Raja and Manila's greatness. But I want to show my work. The least flawed system that I could think of was looking at each queen's PP score, adding those up, and then dividing the result by 4 or 3. 4 for the Headers and 3 for Rolaska Talks. Again, this is flawed as well, but the least flawed thing from the ones I tried. Firstly, this is the point system we're looking at. Let's start with Headers. This is how the 4 of them did on season 3. Oh shit, it's not that easily seen. First, it's Delta. As you can see, her time on season 3 wasn't that stellar, and neither was Carmen's. When it comes to Raja, she did so much better, but not better than Manila. But the two of them were great. Delta has the PP score of 2.142857, Carmen is at 2.3, Raja at 3.75, and Manila at 3.833333, you get it. When we add these four up, rounding up to the sixth decimal, we get an overall PP score of 12.02619, and when divided by 4, we get 3.00654. Let's do Rolaska Talks now. This is how the girls did together. Detox's PP score is 3. Now, if the worst person out of this group has almost the same PP score as the Headers together, can you see what I meant when I said that it was obvious that Rolaska Talks did better? But let's see exactly by how much. Roxy's PP score is 3.54, while Alaska's is 3.90. Rounding up to 6 decimals, we have 3, then 3.545455, and 3.909. And adding these three together, we get 10.454546. Now dividing this with 3, we get Rolaska Talks' cumulative PP score of, oh god, 3.4848486. So who did better on Drag Race? The Headers or Rolaska Talks? Well, of course Rolaska Talks, no question. Even though two of the Headers took the first and second place respectively on season 3, while the other two were 5th and 7th, Rolaska Talks were 2nd, 3rd and 4th. And even just by these placements, cumulatively, we can see that Rolaska Talks did better on Drag Race.